I'm already sensing the backlash. Like, what if McVay doesn't win tomorrow night and all these other...
It's already been asked.
Right. And
it's already been asked. Our friend Jim Trotter asked it today, and it's a legitimate question, and he made sure he clarified, this has nothing to do with Sean McVay. Great respect for McVay. What he's done is off the charts, and Sean, and as you pointing out, Rich, Sean McVay hasn't asked for this.
No.
It's not like he's gone around and touted, hey, you guys should be hiring all the people that I've ever said hello to.
Just
so,
right, just because,
you know, if Sean doesn't win a Super Bowl, what does that say? Well, that's not a fair question for Sean McVay. It's just the second year in the NFL.
That's what I was going to say. Do you know what it says? It says that he has absolutely turned a Rams franchise around, that they would have had a disappointing finish this year, but does not mean that their next several years are in the toilet. And on top of all of it, you know, just because other teams are giving unproven head coaches a shot does not mean that McVay didn't come in with a certain skill set of his own that the Rams rightly saw and hired on their own right. And it's, I don't understand what that sort of resentment is out there for here.
Well, let's be honest about it, Rich. 31, 32 years old, gets his first head coaching job. There's already resentment. Then he has the incredible success year one. Incredible success year two, has a chance to, he's obviously a Super Bowl contender. Resentment grows. National profiles on him. You watch Real Sports, and now he's a savant because he remembers everything, which is something most of us cannot do. Resentment grows. There's a shot of his girlfriend. Resentment quadruples. She's gorgeous. Right? I mean, resentment goes to a factor of 10. And all these things that he's not asked for, he's not presented in that way, but is a natural deal. Just all of us everyone is listening. Think back to when you were younger. If you were in sports, if you were in band, if you were in whatever, and you were the junior or the senior, and a freshman or a sophomore supplanted you, you were naturally resentful. That's just how it is. Most of us eventually learn how to handle it, but you just are. Well, in this case, that's where we are with Sean McVay. But the one thing I would ask everyone who's hired all the so-called Sean McVay clones, Sean McVay didn't just get hired because of offensive acumen. Sean McVay has a presence and a gravitas to him that you feel when you're around him. He can command a room of mature adults like few other people do. And at his age, you had to be able to do that. I hope everyone who's being hired, that was taken into account. Can they walk into the room and make that kind of a statement with 53 people?
Well, I guess we'll find out. Let's get to the here and now. How do you see the Saturday night game playing out? I'm sure you'll be sitting there in New Orleans getting set to call your game like the rest of us settled in to see the Cowboys and Rams. How do you see it playing out, Charles?
Well, I think that the Rams got their mojo back a little bit, and I realize it was Arizona and San Francisco down the stretch. But they executed better, Rich. They looked sharper. And Sean McVay put some stuff on tape in those two games that he hadn't shown much of during the year. Heavier sets, more tight ends, tighter sets at the line of scrimmage where even Josh Reynolds was coming inside, blocking people, you know, running the ball heavily, you know, both inside and to the perimeter, the jet sweeps that he'd been doing. All those things now all on tape, a little bit different, some of it, than what he had shown before. But to me, this game boils down to this. Aaron Donald and Ndamukong Suh are two of the better pass-rushing interior tackles that you're ever going to find. In this game, their job isn't to rush the passer. Their job is to hold the line of scrimmage and make sure there's no gaps for Zeke to get through. If they spend their time teeing off rushing the passer, Zeke will find space. If they hold the point of attack and let the linebackers fill, I think that takes – I'm not going to say it takes care of everything because Zeke's phenomenal. But it makes it harder for the Cowboys to run their offense. And last thing I'll say is Dak has got to use his legs in this game. He's got to pick up two or three first downs with his feet, both scrambling and on some of the called quarterback runs that they haven't done much of during the year.
Yeah, and then the Rams conversely have to run Gurley. And you know, when you said that they looked better last 2 weeks, I mean, C.J. Anderson certainly helped that, coming off the couch and just dominating in the running game. What about Goff with this hot boys front seven and then that back secondary for the Cowboys that has been just lights out for a month plus? We saw what they did to Drew Brees. We saw what they've done consistently. Now they have to come on the road and do it. What's your confidence level in Goff coming into this game, Charles?
My confidence level in him is pretty good, and it rises when Whitworth, Sullivan, Blythe, right? That offensive front, Havenstein, when those guys are moving people off the line of scrimmage and they're running it as they did with C.J. Anderson the last 2 weeks, now they do it with Todd Gurley. When that's happening, now he's back to that being that play-action guy, able to settle into the pocket, step into throws, and make them. The one thing I've admired about him this year in golf is during the bad stretch when all the criticism came, he was the same guy. It never changed. And I know people wanted to see more urgency, and they wanted to see him show he was upset. That's not who he is. He battled through it, played through it, and I believe came out the other side. They have a ton of weapons, but that offensive line for them, which has been intact pretty much for two seasons. The only change is Austin Blythe this year for Jermon Brown. Two straight seasons, the same offensive line. They're going to tell the tale in this whole thing.
The Rich Eisen Show, weekdays at noon Eastern on Audience.